Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.4 Developer Beta 3. This is out to developers and may be out to public beta testers by the time you're watching this, or later in the day, or the following day. It just depends. And this one came in at 279.5 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max, and it can vary depending on which device you're on. Now, let's take a look at the build number. You can see the build is 16G5038D, and this particular build actually has one small change. But let's talk about the actual storage size, since I did a before and after screenshot. So if I go into Photos, prior to installing the iOS update, I had 39.5 gigabytes used. When it comes to system storage, I was using 15.67 gigabytes. Let's take a look at the actual storage now. So we'll go to iPhone storage, and you'll see it's using a little bit more, and this goes up and down as it's installing and then kind of optimizes everything in the background. Let's wait for it to load and we'll take a closer look. So as you can see, system storage is 17.05 gigabytes on my iPhone XS Max. And this can go up or down depending on what you're doing, but I just kind of wanted to give it as a reference, as it seems that iOS over time has actually gone down in using the amount of system storage. I don't know if there was a bug or they fixed it along the way, but it's just something to note. Now, they did update the modem firmware numbers on the devices, so you should have a newer modem firmware number. And I have noticed that iOS has been better, especially with 12.3.1, and it seems like they really fixed it with that version. I've been running that on an 8 Plus, but this is my 10R, which I have my SIM card in right now. So I switch around a little bit, and it seems to be better. I have not had any disconnects with Wi-Fi, which is great, even though it says full signal. Data is working much better, and hopefully it continues to get even better with this particular update. Now, aside from the new modem firmware, they actually updated one icon, and this may hint to iOS 13, and we're not sure, but the feedback icon is a little bit different. You'll see it's more rectangular here, so it's a little more oblong, it's in a slight change. We don't know if this is maybe a hint towards iOS 13, and it's hard to say, but iOS 13 is not that far off. In fact, it's in less than a week now. So on iOS, or on June 3rd, we'll see iOS 13, we'll see beta 1. So that will be available to developers, but not public beta testers usually for about a month. And then the final release will come out in September. Now, other than that, there is nothing more new that I was able to find in this particular update. Normally with these updates, you can assume there's bug fixes and tweaks in the background, and that's about it. Normally they don't do a whole lot more, but I can say that it seems super fast. So everything is nice and fast as far as scrolling. I haven't had any freezes in settings at all, and you'll see it's very smooth, and I can show you that with the Geekbench numbers. They seem to be much more consistent, and I'll show you that in a moment. Now, as far as battery is concerned, battery does take a few days to measure for sure, depending on which device you're on, but it will take a few days to know for sure what the battery is like, but we'll wait for it to load here. And with beta 2, it was pretty good. These are the best numbers, but 5 hours and 3 minutes with about 40% battery life left, 30% left. So I'm getting through the day no problem with these particular betas, thankfully, and iOS 12.4 beta 3 should be no different, but we'll see in a few days with the follow-up. Now, Apple did release an iPod Touch today, and that's probably what 12.3.1 was about. It may have had some things in there for that, but I just wanted to show you, even on older devices, scrolling is nice and fast, everything's nice and smooth, and I have seen in forums so far that this particular beta seems to be very fast for most people. Some people were saying it's not that much faster, but I'm seeing it even on older devices be incredibly fast. And when we're talking about other devices, I don't see anything new with the iPad, but I expect big changes with iOS 13 on the iPad. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores, because I think they've become more consistent. So on my iPhone XS Max, you'll see I scored 4,829 for single core and 11,289 for multi-core. Let's take a look at the history, and it seems to have improved for single core, but not so much for multi-core, but that means it's staying fast. But what I found is on all of these devices, it was actually very good. So let me show you that. On the far left, we have the iPad Pro 10.5. In the middle at the top, we have the iPhone 6S Plus. Below that, we have the iPhone SE To the right of that, we have an iPhone XR, and then to the right of that is the iPhone XS Max. So that should give you an idea or a reference to what you should be getting. And again, I said it's quite consistent, and these numbers usually go up after you use it for a few hours. So this is a pretty good sign. So that's it for iOS 12.4 Beta 3. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description, as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like if you enjoyed the video. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.